2020 has been a year full of adventure and accomplishment. A great year for the record books. I competed in a few pro-level world champion competitions and I won them all. 101 awards, such as World Champion of Agriculture, World Champion of Spelling Bees. World Champion of Alligator Wrestling, World Champion of Rescuing Cats from Trees, World Champion Abraham Lincoln Impersonator, World Champion of Rock and Roll. World Champion Prophet of Doom, World Champion Explorer of Regions Unknown Until Recently, World Champion of All of Sports Ball, World Champion Rock Paper Scissors, World Champion World Ambassador, World Champion Staring Contest, Champion Shakespeare Scholar, World Champion of Phantom Third Limb Arm Wrestling, World Champion Parallel Parker, World Champion of Exceptional Hair, World Champion of World History, World Champion of Disarming Charm, World Champion Psychic Medium, World Champion of Karate Kick-Ass, World Champion of Heat Tolerance, World Champion of Dirty Haiku.
Come quiet. A duel do.
But perhaps the most notable award I received this year, the Lifetime Achievement, World Champion of Art. Being World Champion of Art requires a lot of discipline, hard work, dedication and training. A whole lot of training. But the payoff is enormous. Gigantic trophies. Medals. Magazine covers. Dedicated benches in city parks, and more magazine covers. There's Wheaties boxes, streets named after you, and museums, and even more magazine covers because they just can't get enough of your face. But the job also comes with a lot of responsibilities, and you can't let your fans down. But the demands of fame can be unbearable at times. The spotlight can be too much. It's enough to make one consider faking their own death, a la Elvis Presley and Andy Kaufman.
Shadowy flight into the dangerous world of a man who does not exist.
Jesus and a mighty fire chicken, I came back from the dead. I meditated on a sand dune for 3 days and 40 nights. I saw the mysteries of life and of myself. This newfound perspective allowed me to face many an obstacle and adversity. I fought an alligator hurricane at Lafayette and befriended the witch of Yazoo City. I bested scorching winds so high they could melt the coldest of witches' titty. I swam with sharks and sakura and dodged UFOs in Gulf Breeze. I mastered lightning bolts in Memphis and jellyfish in Biloxi. I found the crossroads in Clarksdale and Elvis' coast in Tupelo. I visited Hank Williams' grave and fought a rattlesnake tornado. And though the road was my mistress, it was time to return home. Back home to civilization and my destiny. News traveled fast. The world waited eagerly for my return. There were warm welcomes. There were cheers and tears. And the fans louder than ever. Everybody wanted a piece of the action, seeking my celebrity endorsement. Share a Coke with a legend? Well, don't mind if I do, Joe Thomas. Don't mind if I do.
This video is brought to you by Coke Zero. Life is delicious.
Refreshing. There was a brief concern when I was bit by a radioactive spider. But legend now has it that I may now have world champion superpowers. Fashionista trendsetter superpowers. Unique fragrance superpowers. The ability to be in two places at once. Mental acuity superpowers. Dancing superpowers. And even exceptional hair superpowers. And haters best back the fuck off. Because I'm working on being the world champion of positivity. And if you have any use for my services, take a number and get in line, because it's first come, first served, baby. And who knows, if I feel like it, I'll be the next president of the United States, POTUS numeral 46. Because nothing can stop my limited awesome, once I put my mind and muscle to it. So that's my year 2020, folks, and expect the year 2021 will be even more awesome. As I intend to be the world's greatest world champion of world champions of all time ever.
Oh,
cope with a legend? Well, don't mind if I do, Joe Thomas. Don't mind if I do.
For the show and stay for the merchandise. Bumper stickers, round stickers, yard signs, posters, cereal box, banners, buttons, beer koozies, trophies, medallions, trading cards, postcards, historical markers, cardboard cutouts, condoms, underwear, and socks. And to preemptively answer your question, yes, we have no t-shirts today. But don't be a crybaby yet. Be a real American badass. Most of this stuff is priced to go. Ka-ching! Cash, cash, money, money, dollar bills, y'all. September 18th, 378 Gallery. Be there or be square.